the 10-minute mark.
Hey, everybody, this is Ron Kuhlman coming to you live on the Success Secrets Revealed live stream TV show, so to speak. The purpose of this show basically is to bring on subject matter experts from around the globe to help you, business owners and entrepreneurs, learn some secrets to increase your probabilities of success and to cut out some of the problems that entrepreneurs and business owners go through during their careers, right? So if we can get to where we want to be with less problems, isn't that a wonderful thing? And I've met some great people from all over the country and all over the globe. And they give their time free to just come here and talk to you and give you some secrets and let you know about some of their services and events they hold so you can even increase more of your learning and access to people. The sponsor of this show is RCS Online Solutions, and that's where we help business owners and entrepreneurs attract, convert, and retain their ideal customers and clients to achieve even greater success. With that said, today we are blessed to have with us Eric. Mr. Swanson, Mr. Awesome Swanson. Speaker Eric Swanson is a 5-time best-selling author, international speaker, and a success habits coach. As a leading professional speaker and success coach, Eric Swanson has been making a huge name for himself in assisting people throughout the United States, Canada, and Europe overachieve specific goals in business as well as their personal lives. He is in great demand, speaking on average to more than 50,000 plus people per year in various industries and careers. He is also both versatile in his approach and effective in facilitating a wide range of training topics. Please help me welcome Eric Swanson.
Hey. What's up, brother? How are you? I'm great, man. How are you?
All right. As we talked earlier, you're not muted. Let me click the button. Can you hear me now?
I hear you perfectly.
Oh, I can hear you. You can hear me, but I can't hear you.
That's what I was figuring.
Let me try this one.
Yeah, it's not gonna work. I'll go out and come right back in. All right.
All right. So hopefully Eric's gonna just come right back in and see if we can get his mic stuff working. Because on this end, it's clearly not muted. But Eric, can you hear us, brother? All right. I'm looking at. It's muted, unmute, and then here it says muted, unmute. On this end, as far as this system goes, it says you're unmuted, brother. I'm at a loss. Let me try a different setup here. Let me try clicking you.
There we go. Bring me up. That's what I was saying. Bring me up. Hi.
Can you hear me now?
I can totally hear you.
You can hear me, but I can't hear you. I'm dumbfounded. You got the whole screen, and you're not muted on this end.
Oh, well. I've been using this for years, so let me jump off and.
Eric's going to try to come back in again, everybody. I want to let you know, Eric does a conference called Habitude Warrior Conference, and it is an amazing conference that I've attended probably 8 or 9 times. I was blessed to actually speak on the stage. If I've attended 8 times, I probably spoke on the stage at least 6 times. And the type of people that come to this conference, the type of people that speak at this conference are so giving, so authentic, so real, raw, and relatable, right? They give up their time, they come to this conference, and they teach you. And almost all the speakers stay for the entire 3 days. I've gone to many conferences where the speakers fly in, you know, maybe they're there a half hour before they go on stage. They speak, they might stay at the end to sell or, you know, process whatever people bought or ordered, and then they leave. But at Eric's event, one of the things that I found amazing was that the people stay consistently for 3 days. And if for some reason we can't go live today, we will come back. I mean, I've used this exact same setup for everybody else in the last 10 days at 1 o'clock. Turn my speaker down, he says. All right. Well, Eric, I don't know. Are you coming back on? Everybody says that they could hear you on Facebook, but I couldn't hear you. That's amazing. Let's try that. I'm going to go to the live that we just had.
Eric, I don't know. Are you coming back on? Everybody says that they could hear you on Facebook, but I could. That's amazing.
All right. Ta-da. You back, Eric?
Let's try that.
I am. It's your actual.
We hear you perfectly.
Okay, you can hear me now. Great. So, Ron, the issue was your little volume button on your computer, you didn't put it on. So.
All right, so it wasn't StreamYard. It was my actual computer that I muted, so for whatever reason.
That's exactly right. How are you?
Excellent, man. What's important to me, brother, is how you're doing. And
always awesome, dude. Always awesome, man. How are you? What's going on with it?
I was just talking to people and letting them know about your conference, and I was telling them one of the greatest things I like about your conference and what sets it apart from other conferences is that the speakers, you know, sometimes you get speakers who, you know, they're busy, let's say. So they fly in, they do their speak, and then they, you know, sign whatever they sign, and they leave, right? But what I notice about at your conference is that the vast majority of people come and stay for the entire 3 days. They go to lunch with people. There's a speaker party. I think it's day two, if not day three, where, you know, people get to meet the speaker, associate with them, talk with them, and everything. So to me, it's really in the type of speakers that go there are more heartfelt, more authentic than in some of the other places I've been to. So can you tell us more, a little bit about you and your conference?
Yeah, man. Thanks for doing that and saying that. Can anyone hear me okay? That's okay. And
that's
funny. So
now that my speaker was my speakers, it wasn't the set there. So I apologize, everyone.
No worries. All good, man. At least we're here. Yeah. So yeah. So let's see. What was, by the way, I'm wearing my my safari shirt today because, you know, I had a man, it was tough. Traffic was tough today to get to here because I got up this morning early. I took off to get into traffic from my living room to my kitchen. And that was excellent. I had a great time. And then from there, I went from the kitchen over to the office. Actually, I passed the office, and now I'm in my Zen garden. But I had like traffic. There was like a traffic jam of my dogs. They were right there. It was crazy. But I'm just playing around. Let's see. My conference is awesome, man. What I did was I grabbed a lot of these amazing friends of mine that are influencers and amazing, you know, leaders and teachers really in the world of success, in different areas of success, you know, from your mindset, from your attitude, your mindset, your, how you think about things, how you scale your business, how you build your business, how you connect with others. You know, that's, you're a master at this with your RCS, you know, online solutions. It's excellent, you know, ranking at certain levels so people can see you. People have eyeballs on you, which is phenomenal. So what I did was I just pulled together a lot of the resources, and those resources are individuals that are there for the audience members. You know, so we have a TED Talk style presentation that's it's amazing. 2 days of solid training, and it's pretty fun. So I appreciate you, you know, bringing me on and inviting me to rock this as well. You know, I love your shows, man. You've been doing these for years, and I think I've been on two or three of them so far. It's great.
And I'm grateful that somebody of your caliber will even come on and talk and just give their time freely. I mean, a lot of people will come on to different shows and different events, but I mean, to just give your time freely. And I see you doing a ton of these stream twos, but
Wait, I'm doing this free. Hey, are we doing this one for free?
I'll get you a Starbucks next time we come. It's tea, right?
Glass of ice water. Yeah, exactly.
I love it, brother.
Now I got rid of the coffee. No coffee, no alcohol, and no negativity.
Yeah, that's huge, especially the no negativity part. I mean, it's so easy to get sucked in and come off track. We got right now, I mean, this video is going to live on, right? But right now we're going through, you know, what, you know, our children will hear about the great crisis of 2020 and know that isn't the election, it's the COVID-19 crisis, right? And
you know what they're going to do. You know how you go in an elevator and you go the floor, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4, all the way to 12. Then it skips 13 and goes to 14, right? Yeah. And from elevators. Yeah. Well, we're just going to, in the history, there's not going to be a 2020. It'll be 2019, then 2021. It's just going to go right past this whole year.
We might need that. We might need a rewrite. Can we rewind 2020? But one of the other things I like about your conferences, Eric, and we'll talk about, you know, whatever you want to talk about in your future events too, but you know, you bring on 33 great, yep, Habitude Warrior conference. I got it in a banner going by, and that's a great success book, right? A magazine you started.
This is a magazine, yeah. It's on influencers. We got to get you in the next issue here. We have 33 different influencers that were on my last stage. It's awesome.
Wow, that's excellent. And now we know that the people, that's like a 2-year waiting list to get on your stage, right? It's pretty exclusive. But one of your events.
Really, 3 years if you're counting 2020.
True, because we don't count 2020, right? But you also give new speakers an opportunity. Isn't there an event on like day 3 where people who want to learn to be a speaker, and there's like a contest, and then they earn the, you know, the opportunity to speak on your stage at a future date? Can you, because to me, that's just a huge give back. I know for me that my business, once I started speaking across the country on internet marketing business solutions, my ability to grow and scale was exponential, because now instead of talking 1-to-1, you're talking 1-to-200, 300, whatever the case may be. Plus it also elevates you. So for you to have, you know, years, decades worth of experience and people on your stages to then offer, not only offer a new person, but train them and then get them on for free. I mean, that's huge. Can you tell us a little bit about that part of your program?
Yeah, sure. Well, we don't get them on for free, but yes, we have a program. You like this word free, don't you? So,
oops.
Free.com. So what we do is we have this program where it's a aspiring speakers contest and training. And what we do is we pull from the first 2 days, and actually we've condensed them down to 2 days now. So what we've been doing lately over the last year or so is we'll pull from day one, and we'll pull from those speakers like Laura Langmire, Sharon Lecter, you know, Rick Denley, just really masters of awesomeness, you know, Alex. He's a huge part of this. And Matt Schaefer, Ashton Harvey, will pull from these speakers, and they'll teach, Steve Taubman as well, and they'll teach the aspiring speakers. So what we do is we invite them. We say we have 18 spots, and they're welcome to come in the next morning early at 6:30, I think it starts, 6 o'clock or 6:30. And they have to have coffee in hand or whatever they want, and then boom, we start training them right away for 2 hours straight, from 6:30, 7:30, 8:30 to about 8:30 or 8:45. And then the actual conference starts right around 9 or 9:30. And then towards the middle of the day, we do a contest with these people who just learned from the amazing top named speakers that I just mentioned. So they're learning all these techniques and principles and carving their message. And you don't have to be a speaker to be able to acknowledge and utilize that information. I mean, we're all speaking. I'm speaking right now, right? We're all speaking on, you know, on if it's a stage or if it's a Starbucks, it's the same thing. We're all speaking and really getting our message out there. So it is amazing. We have, you know, we got them lanyards. Somebody wins. They actually win a microphone. That's pretty cool as a award. And then what's cool is they win one spot on our next stage. And that may be the free thing that you're talking about. It's, they don't have to pay for that, but it's a 3-minute spot on our next stage at one of our conferences. It's pretty cool.
I think that's amazing, especially the fact that they get to listen and learn, see how everybody who's for the first 2 days gets up there, speaks, their opening, their body, their clothes, their language, how they relate to people, how they use the different sides of the room. So they see all that. And then the same people or some of those same people on day 3 will actually work with them for 2 hours to help them learn these skill sets. And you're right. They might not. I mean, maybe they will go on to continue to speak on the stages, but opening, learning to do your whole presentation, whether it's in this type of a setting, on stage, or in a conference room, just is going to set you apart and is going to help you. So I kudos to you. I think that's huge that you're giving back to people on so many levels, but I don't know if people have actually spoken about that to you before, just how big it is potentially for some of these people. I know one of the first stages I spoke on beyond my local areas. I had been speaking at, you know, Chamber of Commerce's and all these other different places, meetup groups. But when I went national, I think the first or second stage I spoke on was yours, and it literally helped propel me. And in the support, the mental, emotional, the support, the comfort I felt there was tremendous, you know?
Oh, thanks for saying that. Actually, you know what? It's interesting you bring up the mental and emotional support, because we actually, what I've done is, we have 30 speakers roughly for 3 days, or yep. We have 20 speakers for the 2 day conferences. And what we do is, you know, and everyone sticks around, like all the speakers stay there for all 3 days because they want to. And I kind of require them to, but what's cool is they connect with each other. And then we'll have like a masseuse there, or we'll have, I always like to bring in an energy worker who will just sit there and help you. If you need some meditation, if you need, you know, quiet room over here, you want to test something out with them. Just go ahead. You know, they're there to help you. So we've had people come on and, you know, they've thanked us. I mean, they've been speaking for years, but yet somehow they got a little nervous, or they got lightheaded or whatever. And they said, you know what, that person really calmed me down. They helped me. And I could deliver the amazing message I was looking to deliver to the audience. So it's pretty cool. The emotional support that we provide as well. Pretty cool stuff.
Yeah, I love it. And I remember there was one event I went to. It was before I actually started speaking on your stages. I went, I saw you speaking in Las Vegas at another event, and I went to your event in Houston maybe 6 months later. But there was one of the speakers who got up there and actually got lightheaded because of the lights. She was in the middle of speaking, and she just stopped, got off the stage, and so many people went and supported her mentally. But even though every slot is allotted to a certain person, and there is an agenda and an itinerary, you allowed her to come back on, speak for her entire spot later on when she felt better. But to me, that was like one of my, I was like, wow, when I saw that happening, both at the support that she, and for me, she's become a friend since then. I don't want to mention who it was, you know, S-E, right? But she's been just, she's just an amazing person. But when I saw her up there like that, I was like, wow, you can still fail and be successful. You know what I mean? So it was an opening, an eye-opening for me as well. So kudos to you.
We all mess up. You know, there's things that are going to happen. You know, technology, you call the lighting. Lighting is technology. You know, if it was too hot for her or whatever the case was, you know, I mean, technology is interesting. And just like we had this morning, right? It just took
my head, you know, and I swore it wasn't my end. I swore.
No, a little tiny of a knob, but whatever. But the point is that we're always going to have some issues. And the thing is, how are you going to, either react or respond? And reacting is usually turns into overreacting. So for me to respond and find the solution real quick, that's what online solutions is all about, and find the solution and move to the next level. And it's all going to be good, you know? So it's pretty cool. It's cool to have the
strategy of. Not to end that note, but I just want to say I highly recommend people, if they don't know, I'd be surprised anybody on my feed or your feed doesn't know who you are and what you do. But if you don't, you really need to check out Eric Swanson. Just Google his name with a K, not a C, and it's Habitude Warrior Conference. Tell me, you held up a magazine. Can you tell me, what are you doing with the magazine?
I think there's a professional baseball player from Seattle or something, Eric Swanson as well. It's pretty funny. The magazine is it's just my gift to a lot of my speakers that have been on my stage over the last year or so. And it's just called the Influencers Magazine. So it's all, and I'm on the first cover. it's all about, I'm the editor and the publisher, and we have people like Don Green, who's the president of the Napoleon Hill Foundation. We have Frank Shankwitz in here, Dave Meltzer, Sharon Lecter. I mean, the list goes on and on. We have about 30 different speakers in this magazine. And what I wanted to do is, and there's an article in here on selling and closing that I share. What I wanted to do is I wanted to share this with the world and really honor the speakers and highlight them in this magazine. So we're going to be doing this about 4 times a year. And it's just like a give back, you know. People love it. We actually had this at the book signing, so people had a magazine signing. So it was cool. We gave away, you know, 300-400 of these at the event, and people would grab it and then go down the line, and the author that was there would sign their page. It was really cool. So that's the magazine. And anyone can pick it up, by the way. It's at habitudewarrior.com, and you'll just see a link on the right-hand side that says Influencers Mag, and you'll get the digital copy right there.
That's huge. That's great, because people might not be able to physically attend an event, but they can still avail themselves of that great copy. So good for you. I hear you got an event coming up soon, too.
I do, man. I've got an awesome event coming up this Friday. What day is today, by the way? Because I have no idea.
Wednesday, I think.
Wednesday? What day is today? Wednesday? So it's going to be this Friday. Yeah, Friday, April 24th. And actually, I'll show it to you if you want. I'll share my screen over here. Let me see if I can share my event screen. Boom. Okay, so I'm sharing this. Let me know if you can just pop that up on the screen. There you go. Nice. So this is the Habitude Warrior conference, virtual conference. We're separating it, Ron. So what we've done is, you know how conferences sometimes they're everywhere now, right? It's amazing. These virtual conferences, that is, the summits, they're everywhere. And a lot of them do it 2 days in a row or 3 days in a row. And for me, it's really tough to sit there, you know, for 2-3 days straight. So I decided to split it into 2 separate days. So I'm doing them now on Friday, the 24th, which is this Friday. And then we're jumping a week later, which will be the May 1st there, and I'll click on this, and we'll just show you the a few of the speakers if you'd like to.
Yeah, absolutely.
All right, so this is jumping over there. Okay, so here we go. So the conference is virtual now, and it's April 24th and May 1st. I put a link there for you for your team right there. It's free. I'm happy to include it. There you go. So all they have to do is hit that, and I'll give you a text link to get this if you want.
I think I have it scrolling right now. Text the word summit to 59925.
Oh, there you go. Yeah, 59925. Yeah, that's it.
It's exactly scrolling right now at the bottom of the screen. So for all the listeners and watchers.
Yeah, there you go. So just text the word summit to 59925, and you'll get an email with this information, and just click that button and sign up. It's just your first name, last name, and email address. And check out the speaker lineup. I mean, this is just amazing. We have Marie Diamond coming in from The Secret. She was in The Secret, amazing energy worker. Jim Cathcart, past president of NSA. We have Nick Santo Nastaso, which took me 9 times to pronounce that name, but I got it. He was born with no legs and 1 arm, and just amazing thought patterns that he has. Dr. Nito Cobain is coming on. We have Mark Victor Hansen from Chicken Soup for the Soul. Dennis Yu, who's a brilliant dude. You probably know him, I'm sure. Sharon Lecter, a dear friend of mine. Shanda Sumter. Joseph McClendon works with Tony Robbins, and is his personal coach there. And let's see, Laura Langmire, Ruben Gonzalez, Frank Shankwitz, Make-A-Wish Foundation founder. I'm going to be joining. Alex Stern, our buddy from Boston. He's the founder of Constant Contact and Handy Cane and everything. Dan Clark, Crystal Dwyer Hansen, Nick Lowry, famous NFL player. Priceline founder, Jeff Hoffman, Dennis Waitley, Dana Lisa Gang, Scott Duffy. This guy, Scott Duffy, hangs out with Sir Richard Branson, like on his island, and just hangs out and plays chess and tennis and everything. Greg Scott Reed, Eric Laufham on sales, and Jill Lublin she teaches PR work. It's amazing stuff in branding. And then check this out, Ron. You're going to love this, man. We have special presentations coming in from Brian Tracy. I'm really excited about this. This young lady right here, her name's Jessica Radetzky, if you see that right there. Her name's Jessica Radetzky, and she's on Broadway, She's been singing and dancing on Broadway at the Phantom of the Opera.
And I met her at your event. She's amazing. And when you see her, right, and you see her and you just see her sitting there in the chair, it's like you wouldn't know it. But when she gets up there and starts singing and speaking, it's like, you know, where did that come from? Because if you look at her physically, she doesn't look like it, right? But she's a rock star.
Yeah, she is a rock star. Exactly. Literally. And I used to know her 30 years ago. I used to hang out with her in California when we were kids.
When you were five?
Yeah, so a little higher. She's just amazing. We have Brian Thompson, saxophone player, who plays with Kenny G and Tony Braxton. So what's happening is Jessica and I put this together where we're bringing in what she calls Broadway Hearts, and it's an organization that brings Broadway stars to cancer to children's cancer patients rooms and sings to them in their hospital. It's just amazing. And we have Elizabeth joining as well as Satomi. And these three individuals are on Phantom of the Opera in New York right now, and which is obviously canceled for the time being. And then of course we have some great co-MCs, Lynn Rose, John Kovach, Steve Taubman, Joshua Evans, Yuri Boy, and Natalie Susie. And that's what we've got coming up. So it's going to be a whirlwind of awesomeness. Yeah.
Yeah. And now, if somebody can't make it or they can make part of it, is there the ability for them to access it? Like you said, I mean, maybe they're, you know, they can only watch for 3 hours. Can they go back? Will there be some type of a recording?
There is going to be a recording, but they have to purchase that. So that's it.
So the live is free.
Be there or don't be there. It's up to you guys. Yeah.
Yeah. It costs you to have somebody record it, post it, and do all that. So it's only fair. But you're offering it free up front. So, I mean, you know, no one's going to complain, brother. And those are that's an amazing lineup.
Thanks, man. Yeah. It's a fun thing. That's going to start this Friday. So it'll be East Coast. It's going to start at 12:30 and go to, 12:30 to 8:30. Your time, East Coast. So West Coast, and Pacific, it's going to be 9:30 in the morning till about 5:30.
That's amazing.
Oh, we're having a virtual happy hour right at the end. That's going to be really fun. And we're calling it a BYOB because, we can't deliver. So there you go.
Nice. So you're giving out the tickets?
Yeah. We're going to, you got to wear your wristband to be able to join.
I love it. I was so popular because of that. I don't drink, right? So when I got the free tickets when you go to your events, you get two. So I would give out every ticket I got. I would give them out to people. Believe me, my popularity went right up. They're like, wow.
That's so funny.
But great stuff, Eric. I mean, you're doing tremendous. I'd like to ask you, I'm asking every one of my guests so far, I will continue to ask them, but can three tips, if somebody is a business owner, an entrepreneur, regardless of what industry they're in, what are three things that people can do to increase their probability of success and just kind of like cut out the nonsense? I love your no drama, serve others. Maybe you can tell us where that comes from, but could you give us three tips for the business owners and the entrepreneurs?
Three tips. All right. That'll take 3 hours. Here we go. So let's see. I'll give you some quick ones real quick. One, obviously, number one is decide to be awesome. You know, I always tell people that. I always tell my students this, decide to be awesome. You have that choice. You literally have the choice. So wake up in the morning, hopefully, and you say, hey, you know what? Today's going to be an awesome day. Today's going to be stellar. It's going to be amazing. What am I going to learn and grow and do today? Okay. So number one is make that decision. Literally make that conscious decision and talk to yourself about it. Tell yourself that you are going to change people's lives, including yourself. So that's number one. Number two is no drama, serve others, meaning this right here. I have a dog tag that says no drama, serve others, NDSO. And all that is, in fact, I'll put it in your feed right here. Boom. Check this out. Bam. It's on there in the comments already. So no drama, serve others means just stop dealing with other people's stuff. You know, a friend of mine calls it other people's hula hoops. You can only you know, use your own hula hoop. I don't know how you call it. Circle it, whatever. I don't know what you do to a hula hoop. Dance with it? I don't know how you call that. But you can only do a hula hoop to yourself. You can't do somebody else's hula hoop. So stop dealing with other people's drama, other people's hula hoops. And part of that is that I love mentioning is nobody really cares. Look, if you come up with an issue, if I call somebody, unless they really care about you and they want to help you and you're reaching out for advice or counsel, great. But if you're not, you're just like throwing out some complaints on things. Nobody really cares. Nobody really cares. People have their own complaints to deal with. So stop pushing it out there. And no drama, serve others, meaning find different opportunities to serve other people. I look for those opportunities. And the third thing I'll mention is this. I use the power of three. What I do is every day, I write down, the night before actually I do this, I write down three names of people that I'm gonna touch or I'm gonna help or I'm gonna send something to. It could be just a little thank you note for no reason. And the thank you note can literally say, you know, I just wrote one this morning again. I just wanna thank you for being you. That's it. Thank you for being you. And it's just really simple, but it touches their heart, or hopefully, and just do something kind for three people every single day and seek out those individuals that you're going to help out or do something with and really like label it every day. You're going to literally write down three names of people that you're going to help the next day. And that's what I do. So there you go. There are three quick tips.
I love it, man. I love it. And don't you also have like where you get online every day and you reach out to like 10 people or something?
Yeah, what that's called is it's called my social media 10x10. What I do there is real simple. What I do is I take 10 minutes every morning for about 5 days a week. Every morning I do this and I reach out to 10 individuals through social media. Whatever platforms you have, whether it's or that you're using, whether it's you know, the name the five or six, right? There's Facebook, LinkedIn, Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat, and YouTube. Those are the six major ones. There's also that TikTok thing, but whatever. So,
TikTok. So,
I call it.
It's TikTok. Actually starting to get pretty big. I mean, I can remember people talking about it like 6 months ago. You know, Ty Lopez was saying, get on it, which is probably why I didn't get on it. But just kidding.
Oh, TikTok's huge.
Whoever starts following you there and starts to like you there, you can then convert them and bring them over to your other platforms. I'm sorry, go ahead.
No, I was just gonna say there are some political issues that are going on with TikTok now. So just be careful, be cautious. I actually deleted it off my phone.
But wow, I didn't know that. Thank you for bringing that up. Everybody, please, before you get involved with TikTok, right? Just Google it and see what's going on. You know,
it's owned by China. There's a big, huge Chinese. The Chinese government owns TikTok, and it's just a big thing. So, you know, just do your due diligence if you don't mind that your cell phone basically being able to get information and send it out of the country to people, then, you know, keep TikTok on your phone. And if you don't like that, then, you know, take a look at it. That's as much as I get into it. So I deleted it off my phone recently. So
thank you, man. Thank you for that PSA, because I haven't heard, you know, I'm not really following TikTok, but thank you for that. And listeners, again, make your own decision. TikTok, just Google it, see if it's for you. But be aware of what Eric's talking about.
Yes, it's in the news. They did a whole government thing on that. So, you know, just check it out. But it is huge. I mean, TikTok, I mean, it's no secret. TikTok's owned by a company over in China, and they call it something else there. I forgot what they're called there. But it's the same platform, same system, and all the information gets, you know, I mean, let's face it. Look, we all know. Facebook, like anything I do right now on this with you right now, those keywords are getting put into the algorithms through Facebook. I don't know if we're on Facebook or LinkedIn or whatever you're broadcasting right now, but those algorithms are being entered somewhere. And that computer, you know, Mark Zuckerberg sitting there going, thank you for all this information. So yep. Somebody's getting that information, and that's all good. You know, I mean, how many of y'all have done this where you put in a search in your phone on something, and then all of a sudden you see four ads come up right there. I'm like, how ironic. That's so weird. Like,
two days later, you're getting, you know, stuff.
Weird. You know, I was just looking for a pink poncho. That's strange. anyway, but it's true. Like, that happens all the time. And I noticed it, you know, about 6-7 years ago. And I realized, okay, well, they're tracking you, you know. I mean, yeah. Everyone does this. Everyone does this. Dennis Youth, everyone talks about this. And you can use it to your advantage, but, you know, governments are using it to their advantage as well. So.
Exactly. The main important thing is be aware of the technology out there so you can both utilize it and protect yourself from it at the same time.
Yeah.
So, excellent. Eric, anything else you'd like to share with us? We've been on here about 35 minutes. The first
one
was my mix up.
This was a great intro. Let's get into the meat of it. All right, let's do it. Oh, no, that was it. Okay.
No, anything else you want to say, man? I mean, I haven't seen you in quite a bit. I'm used to seeing you every, you know, so often, flying out, going out to lunch and dinner or whatever. You know what I mean? One of the other things I like about going on the speaker's circuit, so to speak, is you become friends with the organizers of the events and the other speakers. So outside of business, you get together in your shorts and you just walk, you know, you go to the beach and you walk down the boulevard, you stop, you have a coffee. Everybody's got their laptops or tablets with them, so they're working in between. But, you know, it's just a great environment to be in.
It's true. Yeah. It's who you're surrounding yourself with. Right. And that's why I love it when you, man, you're flying everywhere. I love what you do, Ron, because you take a whole year and you say, you know what, I'm just going to go and you travel from city to city. I know you're hanging with Gary Vee and Grant Cardone and then myself and Bill Walsh and everybody, you know, and Sharon Lecter. I see you everywhere, you know, which is, it's really admirable. I love that. Love that about you.
Yeah. So, and you want to know, I mean, I love that and thank you. But like I said, I mean, when I started, one of the first places I started was having
you put an R in there. How are you
started?
You changed it. How are you doing? That's great. You're actually getting an English accent now. This is amazing. You're Boston.
That's right. Started. I think started, but now let me change that to started.
Started when I started.
Yeah. Yeah, when I started, it was pretty much, I mean, like I said, my second or third stage, it was very outside of Massachusetts in New England, was Habitude Warrior Conference. So part of my, you know, part of my ability to do what I do now stemmed from the associations I made through Habitude Warrior Conferences.
Oh,
so
wow.
You. So I'm super grateful, brother.
Thank you, bro. I'll give you a high five.
One minute, I'm over here.
I got you. Go that way.
Which live you got over there?
There you go. Let me have that hat.
Yeah. Get rid of it. Yeah, well, that's covering the light. I got a light there, too.
All right.
And
we need an RCS hat there instead of the 10X.
I should do that. But I definitely believe people should, no matter what, 10X your life, mentally, emotionally, financially, physically.
You're one of the Habitude Warrior hats?
Yeah. Well, I mean, no drama, serve others. I mean, in order to have any type of success in your life, right? I like to say, I joke with my brother and I say, you got to stay sucker free, right? So in January, one of my New Year's resolutions is to stay sucker free, right? And that basically is sucker. No drama. That's a Boston way of saying no drama, serve others, right? Gotta stay sucker free. Because you just basically you want to focus, surround yourself with people who are trying to achieve and do better and are doing better. I like to surround myself with people who are 3 to 5 levels above where I want, you know, where I am and where I want to be, because I can listen and learn from them. And the conversations that they have, the questions they ask are totally different. You know what I mean? And I highly recommend people go to your events. It looks like you're on your phone or something. I probably should have moved.
I was going to show you you just said, don't be a sucker, right? But
No, I said stay sucker free.
Sucker free, yes.
Hey, what's happening? Just want to say hi, and check it out. I am focused. Actually, that's backwards. I wonder what it says. Oh, wait a minute. It says, suck off. Backwards focus, backwards is suck off. I just realized.
I know you sent me that by Marco. I think it was today or yesterday, and I responded to you, right? There is a, you know, another pronunciation, but brother, I love that. Yeah.
I was like, well, that's funny. Focus is, you know, basically don't be a sucker.
Yeah, suck us. Yeah, I just love it. You know, stay sucker free. Stay away from drama. Stay away from, you know, people who are not trying to better themselves. I mean, statistics have shown that, you know, your income and your lifestyle will be close to the average of the five people you spend the most time with. So choose that. You know, choose who you spend time with. Seek counsel, you know, not opinion. And, you know, if you want to learn something or if you want to write a book, you're a five-time, you know, best-selling author. Am I going to ask somebody who's never written a book how to write a book or why should I write a book? I would contact someone like you. So to me, it's just, I love it, brother. And thank you so much. I mean, anything else you'd love to tell us in closing? I mean, make it count. Okay.
Go to that website, go to the thing, text the word summit to 59925 and get the link, sign up right now. It's awesome. It's this Friday. It goes 30 to 5-ish, and that's Pacific time, yes. And just be there with us. We've got a lot of surprises, a lot of performances, and a lot of amazingness. So learn, grab your, you know, notebook and take great notes.
I love it. And Eric, when you say this Friday, that's Friday what, the 24th?
24th, this Friday, okay. Yeah.
So it's now if the listeners are seeing this and they can't make it on Friday the 24th, they can still go there and there'll be a small nominal fee because they might not see this video for 2 weeks, but it's absolutely something you want to avail yourself of. So if you're spending 50, 80, 100 bucks, you are getting, you couldn't sit. I mean, I've talked to Alex Stern, you know what I mean? And he's like 750 bucks an hour, right? And I sit at a dinner with him and listen and learn. So when you have a whole ton of these different speakers speaking and giving you information, giving you free gifts and free giveaways, if you got to pay 97 bucks or 50 bucks or whatever it is.
$97. I don't know how you got that, but that's it.
Well, because I've been to some of your events before, so I guess.
Yeah. $97. So
you're going to spend more than that. If I go to Capital Grill for dinner with my girlfriend, I'm spending $1.50, right? How about investing in yourself?
What, do you not let her eat?
Well, we don't have alcohol, so that's why.
300.
Yeah, you're right, because and we don't have alcohol.
That Caesar salad's $74. Come on.
Exactly. Just the steak alone was like $54, but the steak is like 24 ounces, so we split that and we get some oysters and some other things, but we don't buy alcohol, so that's what really keeps the money down. Yeah. But yeah, that's huge, brother. You got a great sense of
truth. So if they miss, if they can do it April 24th or May 1st or both, actually, because I'm offering it for free for both of them. And if they want the replays and keep it, it's $97. That's it.
That's so huge. You're going to listen to some great. Stacey Allen just popped on the live. Stacey, you were mentioned earlier, but not by name. It was simply S-E. So you can go back and listen if you want. You played a great role in my personal development, and I mentioned that without mentioning your full name, although I just said it now, so I guess I've kind of given it away, but it was purely positive, and I'm so grateful for that interaction I had. So thank you, and thank you, Eric, for providing the format.
Thanks, dude. I appreciate being here. I got to jump to get on another show, and I appreciate being here, man. You're awesome. You're amazing, and I appreciate you, brother.
Thank you. You have a great day, man. We'll talk later.
Awesome, dude. See you soon.
Yep. Bye for now.